It came from outer space. This was Universal Pictures' first 3D movie, their attempt at the big 3D blockbuster. And so this was filmed to impress. And just look at that telescope. Very impressive. Nothing phallic about it, just impressive. Man and his telescope. Now, what I like about real 3D is that it has this vivid quality that, as much as I love post-convergence, something about having that slight twist quality, just, I know, it gives my brain a little bit more of a vivid feel than the post-conversion variety that we get today. Now, there is impressive backdrops. Now, this being a movie from 1953, you're not going to get effects like you expect today. In fact, the whole thing has the feel of a very long Twilight Zone episode with shots feeling like they're very static, like things stay in one place for a little bit longer than you'd expect in a modern movie. And just there's a lot more dialogue, which is kind of refreshing to be presented with something that is asking you to think about what's going on instead of just being bombarded with things. Though it does choose its shots quite well. It's always picking positions that look good in 3D. It always seems to be looking for something to be showcasing depth and space and objects. So this is, and because it is largely a movie based on talking, telling you what's going on, the camera stays in one place, so you get to enjoy it. And 3D likes a steady camera. This was 1953. This is the year James Bond was introduced to the world in a novel. The movies would come later. This was the year Queen Elizabeth became Queen Elizabeth. And now this has been accused as being the first in a long line of science fiction propaganda, the aliens representing a communist, I guess. My impression of the movie is it seemed to be propaganda actually for the other side. There's a shot where a guy steps on a spider and it's meant to demonstrate how we fear things that look different. Speaking from experience, if you ignore critters in your house, you end up with a house full of critters. Live and let live doesn't always work. Sometimes just being a human requires a little bit of nasty business once in a while. And this movie is suggesting people should be more accepting. You can do that, but what you accept in your life grows in your life. And you could actually ask yourself some questions about this movie. The aliens, were they benign? They just happened to be ready to go when they met resistance. Before that moment, their needs seemed to be ever-growing. And maybe the protagonist who understood them was really just brainwashed into evangelizing and normalizing their presence. I don't know, but it's an interesting movie that can give you some interesting thoughts.